Towards the end of my secondary school, I arrived at this phase where I have to figure out what program to take in university. So I did some research, I looked at this, I looked at that. It was more of a trial and error phase. I started from my interest, what I like, and I went from there. Because if I want to pursue something as a career, i.e., something that I want to do for the rest of my life, it better be something that I enjoy doing, something that I care about, something that is meaningful to me. In this process, my parents helped me a lot. I asked them for advice, and they pointed me to the right direction. My dad, he knew that I liked science, so he suggested to me that I pursue biotechnology because it has something to do with science, and it is, at the time at least, it was a newly emerging field and it's growing in Malaysia. So I thought about biotechnology, and to be honest, it didn't excite me as much as I wanted to. But the idea of it was interesting enough, and since I couldn't think of anything else at the time, why not? I decided to go for it. I applied for a scholarship to study biotechnology overseas, got the scholarship, and was sent to University of Toronto in Canada after I passed my pre-university studies in Malaysia. During my pre-university studies in Malaysia, I met this guy who is a psychologist, and he is the first psychology person that I know of in my entire life. The thing is, psychology is not that popular in Malaysia, so you don't see that many psychologists around. I came to Canada, did my first year from fall to winter because that is one academic year, and then summer came. Instead of taking a 4-month-long vacation like every other student, I spent half of that time in university because I needed one more credit. So there I was trying to figure out what course to take for that summer while everybody else was having fun. Whenever I have the freedom of choosing a course, I always choose a course that is interesting to me. Whether that course is easy or not, it doesn't really matter that much because if it's interesting to me, then I will gladly invest my time and energy in it. I think by now you could probably see my overall perspective on education. If the subject matter is not interesting to me, then I will not be invested in it. I mean, think about it. If you want to spend 4 years of your life in university, which by the way is very expensive, then you should be spending that time learning something that you care about, right? While I was trying to figure out what course to take for that one credit in that summer, I thought about the psychologist that I knew from before. Remember that guy? So I had this idea of trying out psychology for a change. It seemed like a very interesting subject, and I am slightly intrigued by it, so I decided to sign up for an introduction to psychology course for that summer. I asked a few of my friends who took the course just to see what they thought of it, and they hated it. They actually warned me not to take the course. Even though I knew some of my friends hated that course, I took that course anyway, and that was the best decision that I have ever made in university, hands down, because that course was the major turning point in my education and in my career choice. It was kind of like you're trying to find something, but you don't know what that something is. But when you see it, you know that this is it. This is it. So psychology was that it for me. When I sat down in that psychology class and learned all about this psychology stuff, it resonates within me. It fits. It feels right. Long story short, after I took the introduction to psychology course in the summer of my first year and the beginning of my second year, I changed my major after I got the approval from my scholarship and the support from my parents, and that is how I ended up taking psychology. Alhamdulillah.